Hello, it's Sara. And look at this, guys. I'm speeding up a video. This is the Skep art journal page that I did, and I'm just sharing here that I changed my palette a little bit. You guys know that I love bright color, shine, and sparkle, but today I'm using a little bit more of a muted palette. I collaged the background first with some kind of green and orangey papers and browns, a lot of K Company paper. I love it. I love the texture of the paper, but I love to collage, so that's why I did it. It's probably not the best idea in an art journal because it bulks up the pages so much, but after that, I gessoed over that and just muted it down a little bit, and then I'm starting to apply my background color. And so I chose a little bit more of a green blue for the sky and just a dark green for the grass area. And I apply that with a large angle brush in kind of a wash. So it's still sheer color, but I'm establishing the ground and the sky. I think I needed a little more dark there. There, that's better. So I'm trying this, you guys. I don't know. Listen, I got to move along with the times here, right? I can't just stay in the past now. We're working on getting me, we're going to get a camcorder probably in September coming up in the next couple of weeks. I'm going to get a camcorder. Going to try to figure out how to, my hubby will put me, something attached to the ceiling so I can shoot from above. And I'm just talking about how you can add texture to your background. I've been watching over this past year of me experimenting with mixed media. I've established, I like to call it a process that I like. And so hopefully you guys are going to do the same thing. Watch lots of different videos and see all the different techniques and ways that you can create a mixed media background that you like, that appeals to you. So this is what I've decided to do. So first I get, maybe add a little texture to the background, add some base color, and then I like to add darker color by stenciling paint on and some stamping. And I'm starting to venture into different color inks for my stamping. Oh, that one's a cute like honeycomb stencil that I happen to have because I'm making a bee skep. This is going to have some bees, and I just thought that would be cool. But I used a really light blue for that, and that's just adding more texture, more character to the background. Then I've decided to use, I think, an orangey color. Oh, I'm talking about how... See, that's how long I've been a painter. My paints get dried up, but there's still lots of paint in there. So I just pulled out the little paint booger, and then there's plenty more paint. And I'm using that. I think it's called terracotta. And I'm using this flower stencil to kind of give the illusion that there's like sunflowers in the background or something. I don't know. I think it turned out cool. This page really came together. Like it worked out. It really came together how I wanted it to. And I'm just using that same color that I did the sheer background with, but now I'm doing it in full strength through a stencil, just some circles. I love my circle stencil. Okay, now we're moving into stamping. And you could continue stenciling, put as much or as little on there as you want. But I'm using, I think, the brown ink here. I love my script stamp. That's one of my faves. And then these are I went with the green on the grass for the script stamp. I like the script stamp in the grass. Makes it look like grass. Just a lot of different stamping. I think I'm sticking with the colors, the browns and blues for the stamping. But you know, who knows? I may just, I'm going to add some leaves. Excuse me. This is my favorite leaf stamp. This is by Diane Reevely, I think. I usually get her and, I can't think of the names. See, this is, I did this the other day, so I don't even remember. But I love to have little leaves poking out from the edges of the page when I'm doing like a scenery page. Oh, and I gotta add my red hearts. I love red hearts. Who doesn't love red hearts? So yeah, I have some leaves poking in from the outside. Oh, that's my favorite blue halo blue gold. I'm gonna do some circles with that. These are addictive. Making circles with caps, all different caps. You can use pen caps, paint caps, soda caps. Yeah, but that's like a metallic-y green blue gold color. And I love it. I think it's like this is not my usual palette, but you can still see some of the color from the background. All right, I went away and I collaged on all the papers, my focal pieces now, with book pages. I like to draw my images onto book pages and then I cut them out and adhere them onto the page with matte medium. And I like to use Liquitex fluid matte medium. It's just like a really thin glue. And it works really well. Although I think one of these leaves gives me a little trouble. I had to glue it down. So let's see. I don't know what I'm talking about here. Talking about how I'm going to be painting. Going to use that green. So actually, I'm just deciding on what colors I'm going to use. I am using the float technique. I've kind of gone back to my roots in my art journal now with painting techniques that I've been using forever as a decorative painter. And I'm so excited because that's what the art journal has become for me. It's kind of like a mix of mixed media and all the different media. So I'm using ink and paint and paint pens and glitter and glue, all types of stuff and paper. And but I am combining the things that I love to do. And that's what I would suggest for all of you guys is to just do what makes you happy. Don't do it if it doesn't make you happy. I struggled with mixed media for about a year. I watched lots and lots and lots of different videos and it kind of boils down to this now. It's what I love and what stuck with me, and that's my style. This is what I'm considering my art journal style. But it makes me happy. I'm not frustrated. I'm not going to do it if it makes me frustrated. So I'm just continuing to paint in my background. No, these aren't the background. These are my focal images. I decided the flowers are going to be yellow, so they're kind of sunflowers. I painted the bee skep in that same orangey color that I did those sunflowers in the background. And the leaves, I don't know. I think I probably changed the green color. But that's the thing. Go with colors that appeal to you, that you love. Don't, do it because I'm doing it. Make it your own. That's what I'm trying to do myself. And I'm a copycat. I will absolutely, tell you every day, I'm a copycat. I get most of my inspiration from watching YouTube videos and other people's work. I don't. This actually I got from my calendar. I switched over to the September page and there was an angel on there and she was carrying a bee skep and there were little bees and sunflowers all around her. And it just made me wanna. Uh-oh, why is my video being all. There we go. It made me wanna paint a bee skep and some flowers, and I went and sat down and did it. It just was that easy, that quick. So I'm setting those centers in. Oh, I'm gonna put my stems on now. And it all really comes together when you add your shading and highlighting to the background to set everything into the canvas. And so it's not just floating on top of the canvas. So right now, I'm just adding a lot of detail color. Actually, that bee skep takes quite a while to paint. And just showing you, there they are, the Diane Reeveley stamps that I love. Oh, I decided I needed to add a few more flowers in the background that are just going to pull some more of that yellow down and make it so that there's some, at least like other, there's Kirby. Other flowers popping through, but they're just background. They're not going to be focal points. So yeah, I'm going to color them, paint them in the same yellow that I did the focal ones. But see, they're just kind of popping from the background. And I end up adding like a couple more at the very end. But yeah, that really helped. It made the field look a little better. Now on this one, I decided to, when I did my cat canvas, I did the same thing with these little leaves along the edges, but I decided to paint them in solid, but just sheer. Like I'll stick my finger in them. See how I stick my finger to just pull up some of that paint so that they're not totally opaque. On the cat canvas I did, I side-loaded them, I floated them, so that there was like, it was just looked like it was shaded. But I love it both ways. It's starting to come together. It's filling in, it's looking more like a field, you know, or a farm. I don't know where my bee skep is. So I can't really see the top of the video right now. I think I'm just getting out paint, and I'm probably going to be shading my bee skep. I'm shading my petals, my flower petals. And I love burnt sienna. I think this is burnt sienna, this color. And it's like a reddish brown, and it's so pretty. I think I love it. And again, that's why I'm choosing it, because I happen to love it. Someone else might like a different color, and that's what they should use. But for me, it's burnt sienna. I love it. So I'm going to highlight those flower petals too, because I did lose a lot of the brightness. Oh, I'm shading the little added flowers too. Got to shade them. So yeah, you guys, look at this. I'm voiceovering and speeding up a video. And I know we talked about, I talked about doing the real time is important, because then you guys can really see and hear as I go my thought process. But I think that when a video is over an hour long, I mean, I don't think you need to know that much about my thought process. So I decided to just give it a try. We'll give it a shot. I'd like to hear what you guys think about this. And I'll probably do it from time to time, depending on what I'm working on. And I think as of right now, I've done a lot of painting videos, and I don't get a lot of, look how this bee skep is going to all of a sudden get rounded looking just by adding that shading to it. And I do a lot more too, but bee skeps are so fun. I'm going off. But I just want to give a shout out to Judy Dipehouse. She's the one who I love painting her bee skeps that she designed in her pattern packets. And so that's kind of based on her design, how I'm doing my bee skep. But anyway, I have lots of painting videos, decorative painting videos, and I don't get very many views. I only have a couple hundred views compared to some that I get 1,000 or more views. So I'm not sure that you really want to watch the painting. And if you do, I have other videos. So what I'm kind of deciding is, once I get to this part where I've put down my focal images and all that, it's just painting from here on out. Like I'm adding my shading and highlights. There are other ways that you can do that. If you don't like to paint or you're not a painter, use, I would say, like the Faber-Castell big brushes are awesome. You can basically just smudge color on and rub it with your finger and get the same effect that I'm getting. Maybe not the exact same. I mean, you know, it's going to look different, but you're going to be able to get shading and highlighting and set your things back into the canvas by using those. So what other techniques are there? There is, you can doodle around your images and put cross-hatching lines. You can use charcoal pencil, different things like that. Is another way to get smudgy, like shading and stuff like that. I just am I'm using painting because I did it for so long and I like it. It's fun. So that's what an art journal should be about. It should be about having fun and using the skills in your toolbox, you know, using what you love and feel like playing with on any given day. So maybe another day, and in the beginning when I first started this art journal specifically, I did the first couple of pages with my pens, with my big brushes, because I was kind of, I have them and I love them, so I was using them, which is good. I mean, I don't want to always just paint. I want to use the tools that I have. So look, I'm just shading around the center there. This B-Skep is coming to life. See how it's starting to look round and have dimension and all that stuff. So this is a cute page. I was really happy with this page. It except for my words. I didn't like the way my words turned out. I did them with, I'm just deciding, I think I need another B, another couple B's. And I do end up adding, I think, two more B's. But yeah, I was going to say, at the end I write, be leave, be happy, and be you. And I wrote them with my Posca paint pens, which I love. But I think I used the medium-sized point, and it just came out too, because I wrote it in script, and I think it was too, like, fat. The lettering was too fat. Like, I just didn't like how it looked after I did it. But I mean, that being said, it's still on there. It still is what it is. So now I'm adding fine lines to each level of the B-Skep to kind of give it more dimension, to make it look like it's coming toward you and rounded. And I kind of go with darker color toward the outside edges and lighter color on the inside, so it makes it look like it's three-dimensional. That's just the dark color, I think, that I added. Then I'm going to add lighter color. Now, what's that color going to be for? Oh, I think it's time to brighten up my grass to kind of give that horizon line. We're about 3/4 of the way done, just about. And this video was originally over an hour long. So we're at, hopefully it'll end up being about a half an hour, and we'll see. But yeah, look, there I added the highlights. Excuse me. And then I'm going to set them down in with some dark color, probably some black green. I love using black green to set things in. Oh, I'm highlighting my leaves. But that, for me, like when I start to get to this part, it's so fun because it really brings the piece to life. Here we go. I'm adding the shading. Now, that other brush that you see coming into this picture is called a mop brush, and this one was designed by Maxine Thomas. She is a decorative painter that I love. I've taken classes with her. But she designed this mop brush. It's got a little bit of a more firm bristle, and it's to kind of pick up some of the water that I use in the float. And I love her mops. So I don't think they sell them at Michael's and AC Moore anymore. I think I got them at AC Moore. Oh, I'm eating potato salad. I was showing you the potato salad. Had to take a potato salad break. But yeah, now I'm adding the green, the sky color to the horizon line above the horizon. So to separate the page there a little bit. I'm going to go around the whole B-Skep too, I think. I should. Yep, here I go. What was I saying? So yeah, but if not, you can order the Maxine's mop online, because it is, I would recommend it. I used to use just a blush brush. When I first started painting, I just pulled an old makeup brush that I used to have. And I mopped with that, but I really didn't know what I was doing at the time. I kind of was just pushing the paint all over the place. But now that I do know what I'm doing, and it takes time. So don't be frustrated. Don't, you know, hate it and never do it again. It takes practice and it takes patience and persevere. You can do it. It's fun once you get the hang of it. I'm just adding a darker color now, probably a little burnt umber on top of that where I put the burnt sienna to just give it extra depth. So we're getting there. It's starting to look good. I think I'm going to shade behind all the sunflowers too with the sky color. I'm going to shade behind. Yeah, see, now I'm bringing it. I'm shading behind the leaves of the flowers. Under the flowers I'll do behind the bees. And anywhere that it seems like things are just floating on the canvas, I have to set them down into the canvas and make them part of the canvas instead of just being on top of the page. So yeah, here I go around the bees. And I also have a ton of paint in my stash. Like I said, I painted for years, so I mostly use Americana. I use Delta, which is Americana is, what is it? It's Delta Ceram Coat, and Americana is Deco Art. But I have tons of paint. I have, oh, there's Kirby. She came to visit. Sorry, I have to show her. She's so cute. I have, so like I said, I've been adding the Martha Stewart pearl paints, metallic paints. I'm going to be using my jelly plate today probably. And I'm going to use everything. I'm just going to be pulling all types of paints. Oh, I added checks to the outside edge too. I wanted to pull some of that light green up into the top here. And I love making checks like this. You guys can use a stencil if you want, but I just use a flat brush. Hold on. Kirby, stop! I hope that wasn't loud. I just use a flat brush with a nice chiseled edge and some nice watered down paint and pull checks. It's that simple. They're fun. Like, it's really fun and easy to do. So that's what I did here to add a little bit more country color to the edges of the piece. And oh, it looks like I've gone away and come back and I've already outlined a lot of the focal images. I'm going to add one more color. It's probably some dark burnt umber now. I'm just going underneath the edges there, but yeah, I've outlined everything, probably using my FUDE, my food ball point pen. It's a 1.5, and those of you who watch mixed media videos, they're all the rage right now. Everyone's using them. It's a little bit of a thicker line than I would like, but it writes really well on a painted background, so that's why everybody's loving them. And I'll probably outline my bees in a minute. So I did some things already, and then now I'm adding the highlight color, a little bit of yellow to the very, very center of the bee skep, just to add. Yeah, that was too much. Yeah, now I'm coming back with some really bright yellow just in the center to make it look like it's kind of coming forward. I added a bee there, so I didn't paint him yet. Up, now I've got my, see, I've got my food ball point pen, and I'm going to outline the bee skep. And I think, yep, I do. I do each line too. Some people, I mean, like Fran was here, my cousin Fran came, and she said she was distracted by the black lines on certain mixed media pages, and I'm not. I really like them. So I'm talking about adding my words, and here you're going to see I'm using my big Uniposca paint pens, and I love them. They write wonderfully, but yeah, it was just too fat, the line. I should have used the fine point. So I put be you, be happy, be leave, and I could have just left it at that, but then I had to go around with white, and I probably should have just used my white Uniball pen. that would have been much better. But then I used my paint pen and it was too fat. So, you know, live and learn. I'm not an expert, nor do I, you know, I'm just here for the fun of it, guys. Seriously, I am just having fun and sharing that with you guys. And if you can take something away from that, I'm happy. I just want to, you know, share what I've learned along the way. But it's getting cute, right? See, here I go adding. At first, I added yellow. And I don't know why I wasn't happy with that. And so then I added white. I think I did scale it down to the fine point, but it's still not an extra fine. And it was still too thick. I definitely, now that I think of it, should have used my Uniball. My white jelly roll pen would have been much better. But anywho, I tried it. And you could add white highlights all over the place. And I think I do. I think I added in the centers of the flowers. I think I add it to. I was thinking about putting it on the B-Skep there. I could tell. All right, you guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Oh, I'm shading the center, the hole. Look how it makes that look. But yeah, I think I'm almost done. So that's it. Thanks for watching.